210 años del inicio de la lucha de independencia y se incorporan una serie de elementos nuevos. Por ejemplo, les comentamos que la Plaza de la Constitución se encuentra hoy llena de simbolismos. En primer lugar, la bandera de México, que ondea en el sitio en donde los mexicas encontraron al águila devorando una serpiente, imagen que hoy es nuestro escudo nacional.
También Guadalupe se aprecia el contorno del territorio del país, así como la antorcha del Pípila, símbolo de la revolución social, y la llama de la esperanza, gesto de un pueblo que está de pie y ve hacia el futuro. La ceremonia conmemorativa por el grito de independencia se lleva a cabo en el contexto de la nueva normalidad y la invitación a quedarse en casa y sumarse desde allí a la fiesta nacional.
Y como esta mañana lo adelantó el presidente López Obrador, también habrá un momento solemne cuando se encienda la llama de la esperanza, símbolo de unidad y fraternidad que nos une a todas y a todos. Y hacia el final, la ceremonia dará paso al tradicional espectáculo de pirotecnia que caracteriza las fiestas en nuestro país, que es uno de los espectáculos o uno de los momentos también más gustados y disfrutables cuando vemos estas formas multicolores poner el cielo, este manto oscuro con esos brillos y esa maravilla, y que ahora además estará acompañado con música de México. Prácticamente se hará un recorrido, igual como está el mapa de la República extendido en esta Plaza de la Constitución. Así también la música irá de norte a sur, recordándonos algunos sones, alguna música de mariachi que nos gusta tanto cantar en estas fiestas patrias.
Por supuesto, presente ahí la llama de la esperanza, que es hoy lo que más nos debe unir como mexicanos. La esperanza de que como pueblo, como nación, tenemos el orgullo de un legado que nos hace siempre salir adelante. Y hoy, por supuesto, una plaza en donde la ausencia del pueblo de México hace notar la relevancia de su presencia. Y hoy en esta ceremonia se destacan estos elementos.
Mexican national anthem, soldiers bringing the flag for the president, Andrés Manuel López Obrador, to do el grito, although as they were just showing, it is without people. There's nobody there's no people there because COVID-19, usually that big square is filled with people to the brim. This is inside of the Palacio Nacional. That's the place where the executive branch of the Mexican government has its office, the National Palace. So it's not like the White House because the president does not live there. And there we can see the Plaza Zócalo, which is in downtown Mexico City. It's probably okay, that's from, so on the left, it's National Palace. On the front, okay, there you go. So yeah, so there with the red, white, and green, that's the National Palace. On the left is the Metropolitan Cathedral. And then there's the huge flag. There is like something like 15 meters long. And like I said earlier, usually that square is filled to brim with people who are participating in these events. So there's the cathedral there at the bottom. And that's downtown Mexico City. There's a lot of old buildings from the 1800s, 1700s, some from the 1600s in that area. Then there in the background there you can see that tall building, the Torre Latinoamericana, built in the 50s, I think. For many years, it was the tallest building in Latin America. And there in the background, you can see that building. It's actually on the right side. It's a hotel. It's a great place to be if you can afford it for this celebration when it's full of people. So there in the middle there, where there's the white light of the National Palace, there's the president. Manuel Andrés López Obrador. He is a bit of a controversial president. Some people very much love him. Some people very much dislike him. I don't follow enough Mexican politics to give you a reason why or why not like him or dislike him. But that's his wife, obviously, next to him. There's a painting there of both, and first on the left side it was Morelos, on the other side was Miguel Hidalgo, which are the two of the priests, Catholic priests, that began the movement of independence. And then behind them, it's Benito Juarez, a portrait of Benito Juarez, who was a president of the United States, very famous, president of Mexico, very famous president. I think he was the first native Indian, as we say in Mexico, president in Mexico. A very beautiful inside of the palace. Old building, I think from the 1700s. Usually he comes out into that balcony. Hey, Madison, good to see you. Usually the president comes out of the balcony. I'm going to come out in a second. And that big square that you're about to see is filled with people. And when he says Viva, which means long live, he'll say Viva México, Viva the heroes that gave us independence. And then he'll name the heroes. Every time he says Viva and then whoever, whatever, the crowd would respond, you know, Viva in unison. Obviously, unfortunately, because of the COVID-19, there's no crowd out there. So, Benson, I don't know how long you were here when I was talking, how long you've been on being able to see this, but this is the Mexican president, Manuel Andrés López Obrador. And this is when he comes out. And again, a shame that there's he's calling out 12 Mexicans. Long live the independence.
Viva Miguel Hidalgo y Costilla.
Long live Miguel Hidalgo y Costilla.
Viva José María Morelos y Pavón.
Long live José María Morelos y Pavón.
Viva Josefa Ortiz de Domínguez.
Long live Josefa Ortiz de Domínguez. Long live Ignacio Allende.
Viva Leona Vicario.
Long live Leona Vicario.
Viva el heroico pueblo de México.
Long live the heroic people of Mexico.
Viva las comunidades indígenas.
Long live the indigenous communities.
Viva la grandeza cultural de México.
Long live the great culture of Mexico. Long live liberty.
Viva la justicia.
Long live justice.
Viva la democracia.
Long live democracy.
Viva la igualdad.
Long live equality.
Viva
long live our sovereignty.
Viva la fraternidad universal.
Long live universal fraternity.
Viva el amor al prójimo.
Long live the love to others.
Viva la esperanza en el porvenir.
Long live the hope in what's coming. Long live Mexico. Long live Mexico. Long live Mexico. And then usually this time, a lot of the churches in Mexico will ring their bells in unison to this. I must admit that usually you can't hear this very well because there's, you know, that square is filled with people and there's so much noise, people yelling and screaming and clapping that you don't get to hear this very much. There's the cathedral, the National Palace. And then in the background, if you get to see it again, it's that there in the background you can see the tallest, not the tallest, the Latin American tower, which used to be the tallest building in Latin America, built in the 50s or 60s. I think it was 50s. Long live Mexico, viva Mexico. That's the Mexican national anthem that they're beginning to play. And this is downtown Mexico City, old part of the city. Have you ever seen pictures of the old Aztec temples? They actually used to be in this part of the city. They were demolished by the Spaniards, obviously. Next time they give you a panoramic view of the square, you'll notice that big flag in the middle. It's a huge flag. It's like 15 meters long, which is 45 feet long, that flag. And every morning at 6 a.m., soldiers come out and raise the flag. And then every evening at 6 p.m., they bring it down. And that's it. Kind of anticlimactic. Not as exciting as I thought it was going to be with all the people out there. But still, brings back memories. My home country. There's a saying, ghost, you never forget your first love. There it is. Old Mexico. There's the main square, El Zócalo, as we say in Mexico City. Well, I don't know who he's waving to because there's nobody there. Well, there's some soldiers there. Oh, that's right, the fireworks. Here we go. It's a nice view of Anton area. So where those fireworks are coming out is as the Metropolitan Cathedral. My dad actually worked in the downtown area. So, you know, sometimes my mom would send us to go take him stuff. And so, and many times we went to the Zócalo for different reasons. It's a shame there's nobody there to enjoy that. Usually the place is just packed with people. Uh-oh. As we used to like as kids, just seeing the fireworks. A sandunga. So what they're doing is that they're going through, as the fireworks go, they're going through playing some music from different parts of Mexico, different regions of Mexico. Songs called La Sandunga. Oh no, what happened? Oh, did this just go out? I think my stream went out. I apologize for that. From Veracruz, if I'm, or Tabasco, this type of music. That's the Gulf Coast, the south part of Mexico. Or that harp and the marimba in the background. Is more central Mexico music, central northern type of music. No, it's more central Mexico. It's a typical small town band. Mexico City in the Valley of Mexico, surrounded by volcanoes. It actually can be a very pretty town on days that fog is not bad. Southern part of Mexico is El Ajusco, a volcano that I believe is snow-capped year-round. That's more Norteño music, north part of Mexico. Accordion, that's German influence in Texas, northern Mexico. People on their balconies, I think, are family members of the president. That's what I think, if I remember correctly. that's interesting. Accordion music, but it's from a state of close to Mexico City. It's a more central state. That's interesting. Hidalgo Morelos, yep. Or again with the marimba, so that's southern Mexico by the coast, the Gulf of Mexico, Veracruz, Yucatan, Quintana Roo. Cancun is in Quintana Roo, so that's kind of a point of reference. What song is this? Sounds very familiar. There's that song again that they were playing earlier when we were watching this a couple hours ago. Mexico Lindo y Querido, the song about, you know, if I die away from you, you know, let them say I'm asleep so, and they can come and bury me here. Is it me, or does the president's wife looks younger than he is? Maybe it's just because she colored her hair, I don't know. Oh, what song is this now? This looks sounds familiar, I can't remember. Excuse me. Oh, it's late. Oh, never mind. Sounds like a newer song. Oh, yeah, Viva México, of course. They just say Viva Mexico and then they say Viva America. When they say America, they don't mean the U.S. America. They mean like the entire continent from Argentina all the way to Canada and Alaska. Again, kind of a shame that there's a place not full with people. Usually it's just there's so many people there that you can get the energy from the crowd. So it's not as good as it could have been.
Esta ceremonia que acabamos de ver es lo que nos hace sentir muy orgullosos de lo que somos, de la herencia precisamente que hemos recibido hoy como mexicanos. Nos reconocemos en parte de la simbología.
Well, and that's
en los últimos minutos el ver ahí los símbolos patrios, el ver ondear la bandera en todo su esplendor. El ver también el escudo nacional y escuchar sin duda nuestro himno.
Por supuesto, Guadalupe, Rita, amigos que nos acompañan en esta transmisión especial en cadena nacional, en donde todos los medios públicos están colaborando y se han unido. También hay que pensar dentro de todos estos elementos, que además de los que tenemos en este momento en pantalla, ese minuto de silencio por las víctimas que en nuestro país han fallecido por la enfermedad COVID.
All right, Benson, and anybody else that's watching, this is the main celebration, and again, unfortunately, not enough people because of COVID-19.
De todos los
mexicanos. And so I'm gonna call it a night because I'm working tomorrow. It's a holiday in Mexico, but not here in the good old USA. Thank you for everybody that watched, and you guys have a great night.